Yeah, not a bad little dude. He's a little cool. He's not cold, but he's not warm either. But he nailed that like a freight train. They are now active. The second blow up I've seen like that. I might have to go in there and flip and pitch. Come on. They were, on the previous trips, they were just pecking at it. I could barely feel them. This thing doubled over the rod. And using that hook I have on the drop shot, I don't even have to set the hook. Once they nail it hard, that's it. It's a done deal. It sets the hook on its own. Did bring it up about 6 inches closer to the surface, or I'm sorry, closer to the bottom. Yeah, we'll just keep an eye on that, and then with that blow up, let's see if we can't get a frog up in there. Definitely eating and feeding. Sun just came back out. Hey, it just popped again over there. Don't tempt me, brother. Don't tempt me. Definitely brought some on the shore. Oh, definitely, I'm gonna snap it. There. the bank. On these rocks. Frog back. They're all up in this. Second catch of the day. Cool thing is, you come in here and bass fish, if nothing bites, then you come in here and drop a cricket and you'll catch 20 or 30 bluegill, because bad as bass is, bluegills, things are not for, you know, they're just more aggressive. It's a good thing to only stay the size that they get, because they'd run the pond if they were bigger. Let's see if we can get something with the jig here. would stand up, but it's just too windy. Oh, wow. Tell me I got that. Holy crap. I don't feel safe. Oh, man. Oh, that's crazy. Whole tree just fell. That's nuts, man.